Hi, I'm Dr. Trainor. Today, let's talk about something important that doesn't get talked about enough, blood pressure. It's the most important cause of stroke that we can change. For many people, getting their blood pressure checked feels like just another step during the doctor's visit, just another number on the chart. But those numbers really matter. High blood pressure often doesn't cause symptoms, so it's easy to ignore, but it can quietly damage your arteries, and over time, that damage can lead to a stroke or a heart attack. Taking control of your blood pressure is one of the best things you can do to protect your brain and your overall health. Think of it this way. High blood pressure is like too much water pressure in a pipe. Over time, the pressure can damage the walls of the pipe, clog them, or even make them burst. The effects may not be immediate, but they are serious and they are preventable. Today, we'll talk about what blood pressure is, how it affects your brain, and how you can control it to reduce your risk of stroke. Blood pressure is the force of blood pushing against your artery walls as your heart pumps. It's measured with two numbers. The top number is systolic pressure, which is the pressure when your heart beats. The bottom number is diastolic pressure, which is the pressure when your heart rests between beats. Normal blood pressure is less than 120 over 80. High blood pressure, or hypertension, starts when your readings are at or above 130 over 80. There are different stages of high blood pressure, from elevated readings that serve as a warning to a hypertensive crisis, which is how it happens when readings go above 180 over 120. Blood pressure in this range may also cause symptoms like headache, blurred vision, or chest pain. A hypertensive crisis needs immediate medical attention. So how does high blood pressure affect your brain over time? It damages your arteries, making them less flexible and more likely to clog or burst. This raises your risk for two types of stroke. First, there's ischemic stroke, which happens when a blood vessel in the brain gets blocked, cutting off oxygen to the brain. High blood pressure makes this more likely by causing fatty deposits or plaque to build up in the arteries. Second, there's hemorrhagic stroke, which happens when an artery in the brain bursts and causes bleeding. High blood pressure can weaken the walls of arteries, making them more likely to rupture. Both types of stroke can lead to serious disability or can even be deadly. Some risk factors for high blood pressure, like age or family history, can't be controlled, but others, like diet, physical activity, and smoking, can be. To control your blood pressure, you should quit smoking, eat a balanced diet that's low in salt and high in potassium, stay physically active, limit alcohol, avoid drugs like cocaine or methamphetamine, which cause blood pressure spikes, and maintain a healthy weight. Also, if you have any signs or symptoms of sleep apnea, like snoring or excessive sleepiness during the daytime, ask your healthcare provider to get tested. This is treatable and has a big effect on blood pressure. Watch our video on obstructive sleep apnea and stroke for more information. Even small changes can make a big difference. To reduce salt in your diet, use salt substitutes or salt-free seasoning. It's also important to watch for hidden salt and processed foods which are very salty, like canned soup, frozen dinners, and deli meats. Even raw chicken is often injected with salt solution to bulk it up. If you do use salt, using a tongue scraper regularly can help your tongue taste salt more effectively so you can use less and still enjoy your food. The only way to know if you have high blood pressure is to check it regularly. If you've had a stroke before, check your blood pressure at least 3 times a week or every day if possible. To get the most accurate readings at home, use an automatic cuff for your upper arm, as wrist and finger monitors aren't as reliable. Sit in a chair with your feet flat on the floor and your back supported. Rest your arm at heart level, palm facing up. Avoid caffeine, exercise, or smoking for at least 30 minutes before taking a reading. Or better yet, quit smoking altogether. Take 2 readings 1 minute apart and write down the average. If more than half your readings are above 130 over 80, or if any reading is above 160 over 100, contact your VA healthcare provider to adjust your plan. You can also use the Stroke Recovery app to track your readings and share them with your care team. If you've been diagnosed with high blood pressure, work with your healthcare provider to manage it through medication, lifestyle changes, or both. Remember, managing blood pressure isn't just about the numbers, it's about protecting your brain, your heart, and your future. If you have questions about blood pressure or stroke risk, reach out to your VA healthcare provider or visit stroke.org for more information. Take action today and take charge of your health. Thank you for watching.